Hi friends, this is Sajina. Welcome back to my channel. Today we can see pityriasis versicolor. Pityriasis versicolor, it's a superficial mycosis. Mycosis means fungal infection. It is commonly affecting the skin and is mainly caused by the genus Malassezia. And the main causative agent of pityriasis versicolor, it is Malassezia furfur. It was known as Tinea versicolor in the past because it is believed that the causative agent is dermatophytes. Pityriasis means a type of file skin scaling. Versicolor means variation in color. Versi means several. And the disease or the condition, it is mainly asymptomatic, mild, chronic and recurrent infection. And it is mainly affecting the stratum corneum of the skin. It is characterized by mainly patchy discoloration of the skin. And the discoloration, it may vary from hypo to hyperpigmentation with various shades. Variants with different colors are given different names. For example, red colored pigmentation, it is called pityriasis rubra. And if it is black, it is called pityriasis versicolor nigra. Most patients are healthy patients and they seek medical advice only on cosmetic grounds. For example, in Sri Lanka, it was considered as a mark of beauty, that is beauty spot, and is also called gomora, gomara meaning tears of liquid gold. The main parts involved are neck, upper part of trunk, face and upper part of arms. Multiple well-defined non-inflammatory lesions, mainly macular lesions with fine scales can be seen. Hypo to hyperpigmentation can be seen. Folliculitis in hair follicles. And it is known pruritic lesions, that is there is no pain. Slight to moderate itching can be seen in some persons. The main factors responsible for this pityriasis versicolor are mainly host factors. They are malnutrition, underlying diseases, immunosuppressive therapy, pregnancy, corticosteroids, HIV. Environmental factors are, most cases they are reported in warm climate. Excessive sweating is one of the significant predisposing factor. Most sexes are equally prone to illness. Susceptibility is different in different ages and is very rare in childhood. Clinical symptoms, it appears in late teenagers. Majority of cases, they are reported in an age range of 20 to 40 years. We can see peak in early 20s. In India, it is very common in an age group of 10 to 30 years. Not associated with poor hygiene. Then laboratory diagnosis. Different methods are available for the diagnosis. Direct examination or direct microscopy, culture, immunodiagnosis, animal pathogenicity. Following methods can be employed for lab diagnosis. First, we can see direct examination. Here, the skin, it must be treated with a disinfectant to remove the contaminants. For that, we are using 70% alcohol. So, the affected site, it is thoroughly sponged with 70% alcohol to remove the contaminants. Or we can use adhesive tapes. After drying, the edges of lesions are finely scraped. And for scraping, we are using the number 15 blade. And it is flame sterilized and is used. And a flame sterilized number 15 blade is used for scraping from the skin lesions. And these scrapings can be observed using different wet mount preparations and staining techniques. KOH mount with DMSO is mainly used. Methylene blue or Albert stain can be used. And this Albert stain method, one important advantage is that less time is required. Then Parker pink blue black ink in KOH mount can be used for observing the details of fungus, that is for observing the fungal morphology more clear. Then calcifluor white staining can be used to avoid confusions due to artifacts. Then chlorazole black E can be used for the direct examination of fungal elements. Kane's formulation can be used for staining both fungi and bacteria present in the scrapings. Malassezia forms clusters of round yeast cells with occasional budding. Characteristic forms are known as banana and grapes appearance or spaghetti and meatball appearance, and this can be seen in KOH mount And this appearance or this characteristic form is a diagnostic feature of this malassezia furfur or pityriasis versicolor. Then second one is Wood's lamp examination. It is an important method. UV light is emitted at 365 nanometer wavelength. Scaly lesions, they show fluorescence, mainly reddish to yellow-green fluorescence can be seen. And it also helps to reveal subclinical lesions. That's Wood lamp examination. Then next one is fungal culture. This fungal culture, it is mainly employed for the final diagnosis of the fungus. And the peculiarity of this malassezia is that it is lipophilic fungus. So SDA overlaid with olive oil can be used. The ingredients are oleic acid, olive oil, glycerol, monostearate and prunes. Species identification can be done by using Dixon agar. Leaming and Ottman medium gives better results and higher recovery rate and longer shelf life can be achieved. Then modified Dixon medium, it permits easier colony counting, better appreciation of colony morphology. All these media we have seen in the previous sessions. A new medium for the rapid diagnosis and determination of antifungal susceptibility is Dutton Dixit medium, that is DDM. It is used for the rapid diagnosis and also for the antifungal susceptibility testing. Other alternative culture media is DYPS agar, blood agar, etc. A new minimal medium containing only L-tryptophan and lipid source induces formation of brown pigmentation, and this medium can also be used for diagnosis. That's all about the fungal culture. Next, we can see immunodiagnosis. For immunodiagnosis, solid phase ELISA can be used to detect the antibody titers against malassezia furfur serovars A, B and C in human sera. Then another method employed is fluorescent microscopy, and it makes the fungal elements visible and mainly give fluorescence. Green and orange fluorescence will be produced. The molecular methods, RFLP, PCR fingerprinting, pulse field gel electrophoresis, RAPD, multi-locus enzyme electrophoresis, etc. can be used for the identification of fungus. And the most sensitive and rapid identification system in the routine practice and epidemiological survey is RT-PCR, and it is less time consuming and it is accurate. Another method is animal pathogenicity. Colonize a wide range of animals also can cause disease to them. Guinea pigs and Swiss albino mice, they are mainly used and they show hyperkeratosis. That's all about lab diagnosis. Then next we can see the treatment and prophylaxis. For treatment, different topical agents are available. That is 1-2% imidazole creams, lotions, shampoos containing ketoconazole, and also ketoconazole creams can be used. One important difficulty is that application all over the body is very difficult. Then it takes months to recover the normal pigmentation even after the elimination of the species. Itraconazole 200 mg daily for 7 days can be employed, or fluconazole 400 mg for 3 days, or a single dose of 400 mg can be employed for the treatment. Reasons for recurrence are genetic, hormonal, sweating and immunosuppressive state. That's all about Pityriasis versicolor. Hope you understand the session. Thank you.